Good afternoon, and welcome to day 29 of the Earth Month Stitch Along. This is it. Today and tomorrow, we're almost done. So, thank you for stitching along with me all this time. This morning, on my dog walk, I picked up a few things. I actually saw this bag yesterday morning, but I thought that it was a little too far away for me to go reach it. And since I saw it again this morning, I figured, oh, maybe I'll try. And it worked. I got it. Who knows where it came from? It has seen better days. I may use a couple of pieces of it in today's stitch along. I also found this. When I first picked it up, I thought, when I bent down to pick it up, I thought it was metal, but I washed it off and it's a rubber thingy. I'm not sure what it's for. But today it's getting stitched down. I also found this, but I'm not going to use that today. It's a little too bulky, and I don't want to cut it down. And I also found this. How lovely is that? Guess what this is going to become? A flower. All right, here we go. So we have here my substrate, clear piece of a Ziploc bag. And I'm still using the purple thread that I had yesterday because it turned out I had a little more of it than I thought I did. So I'm going to keep using it. And here's what I'm planning to do. I'm going to make this into a vase or a cannon, whatever you want to call it. And this is going to be coming out of that cannon. That's my plan. And I may use these little pieces. These are little tidbits of zip ties that I've had lying around here. I may stitch them on like that. So first thing I want to do is stitch this piece on a diagonal here like this. So, or maybe do I want to reverse it? Maybe I want to reverse it. Yeah, I think I'll reverse it. All right, so I'm going to do it very, very simply. I'm just going to do it right through this handle-like thing here. And we'll do a triple. We'll do one stitch this way. And then we'll come in here. And we'll do another stitch this way. And I think that's actually quite secure. So I wonder if my needle would go through it. Oh, I think it would. Maybe I'll take a stitch right here. Oh, that goes in so easily, actually. Okay, so I'm taking a stitch this way. And I'm going to take a stitch on the other side. Let me see if I can pull my thread a little bit tighter. There we go. Yeah, that works. Okay, then I'm going to go on this side here. And take a stitch this way. You know, we want to have coordinating sides. Not perfectly, but well enough. Okay. So it's a little bit tough for the thread to go through. It seems to be pulling it a little bit. So I think I will take a stitch going this way. Like this. And do I have enough thread? I think I do. I have enough thread for another stitch. So I'm going to go this way and this way. And, oh, I think I have enough to go around the head over here. I think I'll do that because why not? And I can go around twice and then I'm going to have to tie off my thread because that's the end of it. Oh, I'm leaving it very short for myself. This is going to take some finagling, so I'm going to go in with the sharp end, but I'm not going to pull it all the way through, and I'm going to go out with a dull end, and if I pull it all out, okay, I have to cut this off right here. Okay, and there we go. All right, so that little bottle is in place. So now I'm going to stitch on this gum wrapper. Let's see, is it better this way? No, it's a little more colorful this way. Okay, so I have more of that same thread. I just need to tie a knot at the end of this one. And I am going to stitch it down. Oh, I don't know. I think maybe just 3 stitches will do it. Let me see, how close can I get it there? There, I can get it pretty close. Okay, let's see. No, I did not wash this piece because I was afraid if I washed it, it would fall apart. So I'm just stitching it on just the way it is. And I'm not going to investigate whether there is actual gum inside. I think it's a gum wrapper. I'm not 100% sure exactly what it is. So, but I think it's been in the forest for a very, very long time. So I think it's pretty benign now, aside from the fact that it will never actually disintegrate in the forest. So thus we're making art with it. Okay, so I'm just stitching it down with a few random stitches. I call this my ladder stitch because you can see how it kind of looks like a ladder. And this is what it looks like from the back. Oh, and I tied a knot at the back. Huh. But this is what it looks like at the back. So it's just, they kind of look like a little burst of, I don't know. They can look at like stamens from a flower. We can choose to decide whether this is a flower or a bottle of champagne with bubbles coming out. You can be pretty silly about this stuff. All right, so I'm just taking a stitch here to tie this off. I don't want to pull too tight because it'll probably rip, but this should be fine to keep in place. All right, so now the question is, I have these 2 little pieces of zip tie that I can sort of add decoratively to the side here. Oh, I have this plastic bag that I found. Do I want to use the plastic bag or the zip ties? You know what? I think I'll use both today. So I'm going to give it a little bit of grounding with this black zip tie piece because that's going to go down here. And it's just, you know, directional. This is sort of an abstract composition that could be something. Maybe it's not, but I am just kind of winging it here with a few directional. So all my pieces will be going in the same direction, and that just gives a visual interest to the little piece. I think I have pretty much decided that all the pieces that I've stitched so far, I'm going to put together into a little book. I think that's going to be my plan. I'm going to try to do that next week. Hopefully I'll be able to do that. Shouldn't take me too long. But I'm also reserving the ability to change my mind. Just because today I've decided it's going to be a book, I may change my mind when I actually start working on all the pieces. And maybe I'll make it into something else. That is my prerogative, to change my mind. Okay, so I'm just going to tie this off right here. There we go. Oh, thanks, Michelle. Yep, garbage. Garbage into art. That is my specialty. Because, well, why not? Why not? Okay, so a little more thread. I think I'm going to add this white piece right here. This is the ends of Ziplocs that I have zip ties that I had used different portions of it in other little pieces earlier in the month. I actually don't remember which pieces they were now, but I'm sure once I pull them all out and look at them all, I will remember. Okay, so I'm just going to finish this off right here. There's this piece. I'm just hooking through this final stitch, and then I'm hooking through again, just so I can have a knot to tie here. There we go. Okay, so clearly the composition needs a little bit something right here. What should it be? Let's see, what part of this bag can I use? Oh, would it be appropriate? Ah, I think this little part right here is going to be very appropriate to stitch down right there. Because it would certainly speak to what is in this little artwork. Yep. All right, I'm going to make a statement here. I'm going to stitch down this little guy. Maybe I'll, yes, I think I'll put it on the side like this. And I'm just going to do it with a couple of really basic stitches. I'm just going to do a nice long stitch underlining things here. And then just take a couple of stitches here. Thanks, Michelle. I'm so glad you're here. It's nice to see you. Okay, let's give this guy a little scarf. Okay, so none of this is serious art. This is just for fun and for exercise, but I'm hoping that you can see how easy it is to stitch through all sorts of ridiculous things so that later on you can make some slightly more serious art with it. No art needs to be serious. It can all be just for fun. There's nothing wrong with that. Okay, there. I've tied that off. And there is my art for the day. This is today's Earth Month Stitch Along, day 29. Thanks for being here. I'll see you tomorrow for the final day. I can't believe it. Final day tomorrow. Thanks for being here. Bye.